Looking forward to meeting even more Game of Thrones fans.
Yeah, it's crazy. It just kind of gets bigger and bigger and bigger. I was here last year, and already this is Friday night, and already there's just queues of people. It's nuts.
What do you think makes Thrones such a phenomenon? I mean, of course, up for another bag full of Emmys again this year.
Yeah, what makes it a phenomenon? I guess it's hard to say. A lot of things. It's the characters, all the different detailed characters, the amazing sets, the brilliant writing. But I think what really, really sets it apart from everything else is it's kind of mythology. It's this fantasy program, which is it's just amazing. It's amazing. It's very kind of esoteric, and you know, ice and fire, and it's the unknown, you know. But yeah, it ties it into the real world, and it's quite hard to say what makes it such a success. But I don't really know. It's weird. Favorite character from the show. I really like the dragons this year. That last scene where Daenerys locks up the dragons was really like, wow. She's fucked herself up there by locking the dragons away. But characters, I don't know, man. I love them all so much. Brienne, Gwen's just amazing. Maisie is Arya, is incredible. Alfie is Theon. Lena is Cersei. Charles Dance is Tywin. There's just so many. Everyone's brilliant.
You mentioned Alfie there. Obviously, his torture scenes and the Red Wedding episode have kind of raised a lot of debate about the level of violence in the show and how necessary that is. I mean, how do you feel, and what was your reaction when you watched the Red Wedding episode?
I love the Red Wedding. I thought it was brilliant. I think the stuff with Alfie is really, really intense. Like, I know Alfie really well, and he's a good mate of mine. And when I watch that stuff back, I find it really difficult to watch, to be honest, because it's, you know, it's my mate, and he's getting really mentally tortured and physically tortured, and it's not nice to watch because, you know, I know him so well. If I was watching it as an audience member, I think it'd probably be fucking cool, you know. I think they've got the level of violence just right. You know, it's not too much. It's not gratuitous. I think if it's something like Hostel or something, no, not Hostel. Hostel was a good film. Something like the Human Centipede. When the violence starts to become gratuitous and doesn't have a place within the narrative, then it starts to get a bit like seedy, a bit pointless. But I think Thrones does a good job of just keeping it dark and like unwatchable, but still maintains its integrity.
Do you have a fondest memory from set?
Wow, I have so many great memories from set. Something I remember, it wasn't from set, but last year there was a whole bunch of us that took a boat out around the Croatian islands. I think it was, who is it? It was me, Gwen, Lena, Charles, Peter, Nikolai, Pedro. There was a whole bunch of us, and we were on this wonderful little yacht just cruising around the islands, listening to disco songs, drinking wine, jumping in and out of the sea. It's wicked. It's really nice. It's really nice that the cast bind together so well. And I think we all know how lucky we are to be in such a mega hit of a show. It's magical, man. It's amazing.
We're so happy we're going to get many more seasons. What are you most looking forward to in terms of...
Oh, the ending. The ending, man. We're getting so close now, and things are really starting to wrap up. People are starting to take sides. You know, the fact we saw that Ice King guy in season four, like, what the fuck was that? When Bran touched the tree and he had these visions, you know? Now that Tyrion's gone, what it looks like, to side with Daenerys, it's all just, like, falling into place. And, I have no idea what's going to happen in the end, but I'm really excited about it, and I think it's going to be... It's like one of these things, you know, you think the show's halfway through now, or it's season five, so we've got, what, two more seasons after season five to go, and you think, God, man, it must be running out of steam. But in fact, it's all this last half which is going to be the most explosive stuff. That's the stuff that's going to be, like, the most entertaining of all to watch. So... yeah, I just hope that Loras survives and he can see it through to the end, and he's fighting. I don't know what side he'll fight for, but I really hope to see him at the big battle of ice and fire, like, getting stuck in there and, like, yeah, taking people down.
Have you got a message for fans before you get back to fans here today?
Oh, message for fans, wow. Just, I guess, thank you. It's really amazing to come to these shows and go all around the world and have people not only, you know, it's one thing getting recognized for stuff, you know, but it's people have so much love and passion for it. They really care about it. And to be involved in something which is someone else's passion, it's the best feeling in the world.